In this lesson, we will discuss the different types of similarity in modeling studies. Before building a full-size prototype, we sometimes conduct a modeling study to help us predict how the prototype would behave under a particular set of flow conditions. In order for the results from the modeling study to be useful for making predictions, we need to ensure the model and prototype meet a few similarity requirements. The first type of similarity requirement between the model and prototype is geometric similarity. Geometric similarity between the model and prototype is attained if all dimensions of the prototype are scaled by the same factor when constructing the model, and both the model and prototype have the same orientation relative to the flow. Geometric similarity can be thought of as length scale equivalence between the model and prototype because the ratio of any length in the model, LM, to the length in the prototype, LP, is constant, and we will call that constant lambda L. Here we have a square column that is being subjected to flow on one side. Geometric similarity is attained if all dimensions of the model are scaled down by the same factor, lambda L, and the model and prototype experience the flow along the same side, which is what we see here. Now let's look at two examples of where the model and prototype do not have geometric similarity. On the left, the width and height of the model are scaled down by the same factor, but the length into the page is identical to the prototype, so all lengths are not scaled by the same factor. On the right, the model has been scaled down by the same factor in all dimensions, but it has a different orientation relative to the flow compared to the prototype. The second type of similarity between the model and prototype is kinematic similarity. Before we can discuss kinematic similarity, we must first introduce the concept of homologous points. Homologous points in the model and prototype are points that are located at the same relative position to the system we are studying. For example, let's say we are studying flow over a sphere. The prototype is located on the left and the model is located on the right. The red points in the prototype and model are located at a position that is parallel to the top side and parallel to the left side of the sphere, and so the two points are homologous. Now let's draw a couple more pairs of homologous points, and include the velocity of the flow at those points. To attain kinematic similarity between the model and prototype, the velocity vectors at all homologous points must point in the same direction and be scaled by the same factor. Attaining kinematic similarity can be thought of as attaining timescale equivalence between the model and prototype. And we can understand this better by looking at the relationship between speed and time for homologous points. The distance traveled by a fluid particle is equal to its speed multiplied by time. For the prototype, we can write this relationship as length LP equals speed VP multiplied by time TP. For the model, we can write this relationship as length LM equals speed VM multiplied by time TM. The ratio of LM to LP is VM TM divided by VP TP. Rearranging this equation, we have the ratio TM over TP is equal to LM over LP multiplied by VP over VM. LM over LP is the length ratio of the model to the prototype, which we call lambda L. Assuming that we have geometric similarity, lambda L is a constant. VP over VM is the velocity ratio of the prototype to the model, which is also constant throughout the flow if we have kinematic similarity. This means TM over TP also is constant throughout the flow, and we're left with an interesting conclusion. When conducting a modeling study, time is scaled up or scaled down compared to the prototype. For example, let's say lambda L is 1 over 10, and the flow speed in the prototype is 5 times larger than the flow speed in the model. This means the ratio of TM over TP is 1/2. In other words, running the model for 1 minute is equivalent to running the prototype for 2 minutes. Time is effectively sped up by a factor of 2 in the model. The third type of similarity between the model and prototype that we should try to attain is dynamic similarity. Dynamic similarity means that all forces at homologous points are scaled by the same value. For example, here we have flow over a thin rectangular panel. The path taken by a fluid particle over the panel is due to the relative strength of the forces acting on the fluid particle, such as pressure, friction, buoyancy, and gravity, and these forces may vary in space. If dynamic similarity is attained, the forces at homologous points in the model are all scaled by the same factor. The way that we attain dynamic similarity is by ensuring that the pi groups involving force ratios, such as the Reynolds number, Froude number, and so on, are equal in the prototype and model. If geometric similarity, kinematic similarity, and dynamic similarity between the model and prototype are attained, we say there is similitude between the model and prototype. If similitude exists, the modeling results should accurately predict what will happen to the prototype. As discussed in previous videos, when conducting modeling studies, we start by developing a set of n-k pi groups, where n is the number of variables relevant to the problem, and k is the number of reference dimensions. The similarity requirements specify how to run the modeling study so that the results from the model can be used to predict the behavior of the prototype. The similarity requirements are pi 2 of the prototype equals pi 2 of the model, pi 3 of the prototype equals pi 3 of the model, all the way to the last pi group of the prototype equals the last pi group of the model. If we're able to meet these similarity requirements, similitude is attained and we can use the prediction equation to predict the behavior of the prototype. Pi 1 of the prototype would equal pi 1 of the model. While we always should try to achieve similitude whenever possible, in practice it may be difficult to meet all of the similarity requirements. If even one of the similarity requirements are not met, we say the model is distorted, and pi 1 of the prototype will not equal pi 1 of the model. But depending on which similarity requirement is not met and the specific circumstances of the modeling study, the prediction equation may still produce useful results. One common example of a model being distorted is when dealing with surface roughness. Let's say we're trying to build a model of a rectangular panel in order to study the drag caused by wind. In order to attain geometric similarity, not only do the length, width, and thickness of the panel need to be scaled by the same factor, but the surface roughness epsilon should be scaled by the same factor as well. In most modeling studies, it's not practical to scale down the surface roughness, and so the model will be distorted as a result. But in this particular scenario, where the incoming flow is perpendicular to the surface of the panel, this distortion likely won't matter because the drag is caused mostly by flow separation at the edges of the panel and not by surface roughness. The topic of distorted models will be covered in greater detail in the next video.